the Canadian press.
This is the morning after. It's a peaceful scene on this river valley, just a hop and a skip from Kandahar. What a difference a day makes. The armed checkpoints nearby hint at what has happened here. A Canadian military convoy arrives to have a look. Just a day ago, Taliban fighters declared themselves in charge of villages along the Argandab River. They hid in the bushes on the other side. Canadian forces, Afghans, and their allies attempted to cross that river, and they came under heavy fire. After a false start, they regrouped. NATO aircraft came in, dropping bombs. The Taliban, outnumbered and outarmed, were finally outmuscled from the area. The governor of Kandahar says there are just some landmines and explosives that need to be cleared, and the people who fled their villages can come back. It's fruit harvest time. The locals are in a hurry to get back to their farms. They face financial ruin if their fruits are allowed to rot. The governor, Asadullah Khalid, says hundreds of Taliban were killed or injured in a rout along this river. He says he can't even keep count of all their casualties.
Now I can't tell you how many, because this is changing every minute. We are finding more bodies, more wounded people, and more livestock.
The Canadians are sounding a less triumphalist tone. Dennis Thompson, Canada's top soldier in Afghanistan, says there are still a few rebels in the area.
They're just not here in any meaningful numbers.
Meaningful numbers? What?
Hundreds, fifties, they're here in small numbers. They've been defeated for the most part.
Okay.
And until the police can go to every village and assure the authorities, then it's not possible to say that it's safe enough for the people to come back yet.
It's not quite safe yet.
Where did they go? Are they still in the area or they left the area for somewhere else?
They're trying to escape, that's true, yes. I can't tell you where they're going because clearly that would not be to our advantage.
He's well aware of the history here. The Taliban have been run out of this area before, only to return. The insurgents never win on the battlefield. After each loss to coalition armies, they slide away, hide amongst civilians, and plan their next strike with explosives, suicide bombers, assassinations of public officials and police officers, or, as with last week's prison break, sometimes a combination of the above. Thompson says police need to maintain a presence here, and construction projects need to start quickly while the Taliban are in retreat from the area. Or else, they'll be back in this valley before too long. Alexander Panetta, The Canadian Press, Kandahar.
The Canadian Press.